I'm Dr. Eugene Shapiro from Yale University. I'm here at the annual meeting of the Pediatric Academic Societies in Vancouver, Canada. And I'm going to talk about a study that we did and regarding Lyme disease. In particular, we looked at referrals to our Pediatric Infectious Diseases Clinic at Yale, and we found that of referrals from outside folks, more than half of all referrals were for Lyme disease. When we then looked at those particular patients who were referred and the evaluation that was done, we found that between 80 and 90%, in fact, did not have active Lyme disease, but had chronic symptoms likely unrelated to Lyme disease, which we term medically unexplained symptoms. We then actually called a sample of those patients to find out what proportion, what happened to them after they left our clinic. And we found that approximately half of the parents were not happy with the results of the consult visit. We found that nearly half of them received additional treatment for these ongoing symptoms, and we found that it was very common, more than half sought other providers other than their primary care physician because of the symptoms. It's very clear that simply telling parents that Lyme disease is not the cause of these non-specific symptoms, such as fatigue, various pain syndromes, that is not sufficient, and that we need a new paradigm to how to best manage such patients. Often it's not the pediatric infectious disease specialist who doesn't have an ongoing relationship with these patients who is likely to be the best, but somebody who can develop a trusting relationship with them. Very frequently, these parents and patients are seeking affirmation that these symptoms are real, and in fact, they are real. It's just that they're not caused by Lyme disease. Consequently, we need to figure out ways to try to reduce healthcare seeking behaviors where patients are trying to often get treated with unnecessarily with antimicrobials. So that's one of the interesting and probably the most important aspects of what's going on with Lyme disease today.